So today is Kenyan Day. I call it Kenyan Day not because I fly to Kenya like some people think. It's because I do a run specific day. I run three times in the day. I wake up, have a coffee, and then a little espresso just to get me awake, do a nice easy jog, about 3.5-4k, go to the cricket pitch, I crack on with some strides, do a bit of stretching just to try and open up the hips. I tend to get quite a tight lower back and hip flexor, so in doing strides with some static lunges I find really helps free my hips up, which, you know, I can really get into my stride. And this is crucial for the big sessions later in the day. Once I've done my strides, again, another 3-4k jog back home, a nice breakfast, normally some jungle oats, and another coffee, just a bit of a chill. I drive up to a place at the top end of Stellenbosch called the Yamaris Nature Reserve, a beautiful spot. It's no dogs allowed, so that's bloody good because they always chase me. And then I do 10k worth of work, 6 mile reps with a minute 15 recovery, running at a constant pace. No world records, just good honest hard work, you know, because obviously the day before and the day after is just as important as the day I train on. It's a solid session, doing it at 11 o'clock, so some days it can be 35 degrees, some days it can be 25, because it's only February, March time. So as I say, you know, it's a session I like to progress on to the tartan track later in the season. Go and grab some lunch, normally head to one of the cafes in Stellenbosch, there's some great organic cafes, or come home and have a nice chicken salad or a nice toasted sandwich. Always have another coffee as well, I just find it really helps. Had umpteen today. Then the rest of the afternoon I just kick back and chill. Sometimes my wife goes to the gym, so I'm looking after our daughter Matilda, which is always a pleasure, puts a big smile on my face. And then in the evening I go up to the big nature reserve at the way far end where all the mountain bikers hang out. I call it my MMM session, my medium, moderate and mad. And basically it's 12 minutes, 12 minutes, 12 minutes, 12 minutes, finishing absolutely balls to the wall. You know, you hang it on the line. And again, you know, after that 10K at lunchtime and then the early morning run, it's a lot of running. So it's, you know, close to just over 30K, of which hopefully, you know, 15 to 18 kilometres is close to race pace. Yeah, and that's a real tough session because it's always windy up there, you know, and the fitter I get, the earlier I do it. So it's hotter. Also, yeah, with the wind and it's quite a hilly loop, it's really awesome. The last 3K is slightly downhill, so I find that really helps build my leg speed. You can just see at the end of a triathlon, people's stride cadence goes right down and their length. So, you know, running fast downhill I find really helps me keep my stride length, but also the cadence up as well. So today I start my day with a swim. Pierre's our coach. I've been swimming with him since 99 every winter, and actually in the season he often comes to watch me race and does a bit of training blocks when I've trained at altitude before. He's got a great understanding of distance freestyle and open water. You know, the fact that you've got someone like Hirden in the pool, who's the Commonwealth silver medalist for 1500, you know, it really gives you confidence and faith in what he does. And you know, there's some world-class triathletes train here as well, so no, it's awesome. Sessions are often quite long and arduous, but you know, if it was easy, I guess everyone would be an international triathlete. But no, it's a great atmosphere, and we get the hard work done day in, day out. And you know, I really enjoy this part of the day. And then today I jump out on the bike for just over 75k, and I do half an hour over gear work. So I put it in the 53.11 wild boy style, and basically just hold best pace, you know, really looking at my watts when I got my SRM meter on. And you know, again, I keep the data, so you know, during the winter I can see progression in that. And I think watts are one of the honest ways to record your performance, because there's often speed is great and average speed and heart rate, but to do with illness and wind and the type of road, I do it on the same circuit, so you know, it's a really good benchmark for me. Some people ask, why do I do a fair bit of over gear work? I would love to ride 600k a week and be fantastically strong on the bike, but I just physically can't fit that in with my running and swimming. So we do a few shortcuts, so to speak, to put strength there, to put areas of the biking that we need. And one of the ways I find I get a lot stronger is by doing over gear work. It's a really hard session. I'm on my SL3 at the moment, which is a sweet piece of kit. I'm looking forward to getting the Venge later in the year. I've heard that's dirty fast, which is what I like. After that session, again, head back home, nice bit of lunch, just chill. And then we head up to a race pace and over race pace session. I alternate it with a track, and then I use a treadmill quite a bit, because again, the track can be quite demanding when you're trying to run fast. It can take a lot out of your legs, and obviously, as I've always said, the day before and the day after are just as important as the day I'm training. So I use a treadmill, which I find is a lot softer, and again, I really find it helps with my leg speed, which I'm a big believer in, especially the back end of a triathlon. When I've had my best races, I've had great leg speed for myself, and you know, treadmill really encourages that. So I do a nice warm-up, and then I do run-throughs. So it's 15 seconds on, 15 seconds off, and I start at 20 kilometres an hour. And after each 15 seconds, I go up by half a kilometre an hour, up to 25k an hour. And I like to do that kind of session at about 2% gradient. Then I jump off, have a stretch, and six times a K with a minute and a half rest. Yeah, so I normally start, and I try and hold three at a solid pace, and then I descend the last two. I think today we're starting at 2:47, then we drop down to 2:44, and then hopefully about 2:40, and then dipping under 2:30 for the last one. And then, yeah, no, a nice easy jog, warm down. And yeah, sometimes I've got someone working on the machine, so I've got Pete here, who's the specialised soigneur, so it's great to have, you know, someone who's going to be at all the races with you. They see all the hard work that you put in, you know, so they're really, really prepared to go the extra mile, which is, it's just a great team atmosphere at the moment. Some people say, oh, the nicest session of the day, but as you can see by my face and by the size of the brute that's doing it, I have a massage late afternoon, early evening by Frankie Peanuts. Who is a world-class masseur, and I think most of the top athletes that come through Stellenbosch see him. You know, it's an integral part of our training, it really is. You know, we're trying to get the most out of our body. You know, you've just seen 48 hours of what I do, and, you know, along with that comes massage, physio, stretching that you don't see, and it really is a case of meticulous planning. You know, we don't just turn up and go Harry hard and win. You know, there's a lot that goes in it, so... Yeah, hopefully you've enjoyed the 48 hours with myself. Yeah, look out for me on the circuit. Hopefully I'll be on the podium, climbing higher and higher as 2012 comes on. If you're around at the races, come and say hello, and yeah, give us a shout and a bit of a G up.